Continuing my exploration. Next, I'll be headed towards this regional office again. And that should cover most of this area. Once I'm done with that, I'll head north towards this Memorial Bridge and explore this area up here, which should help make Ten Pines more secure. That is the thought, at least. It does not take long for these ghouls to come back. I suppose that can be explained by the fact that Cambridge is a large city or a large town, so there are constantly ghouls being unearthed. Memorial Bridge is to my left. This leads to another one. And the office is not that far away. Light arms fire. Given it's Cambridge, it is. Okay, a car just went up. Okay, now to explore this and explore a little bit around Bunker Hill some more and then head towards that bridge. Shooting at something, but it sounds like that's a turret shooting. Because it's shooting, adjusting, shooting, adjusting, shooting. That's the end. That's why it's doing that. Leave your own.
This outfit's way worse.
Hearing shit.
You sure you saw something?
No, I thought that was where.
End of the line!
Raider scum, huh? So was that an initiation? Or more than one faction, a raider?
It's called shooting straight. Playing games with me, huh?
Okay, named. I'm not usually good at coordination.
Keep your
so.
Eyes open. I think this asshole's using the stealth boy.
So I've got him mostly under me. few on the same level.
When you turn up, you're dead.
Plus, I've got that turret.
Come on, I dare you.
Unknown that the turret is lined up with him, but it'll probably attack me as well.
No sign of him now.
Don't you die on me! No need to hide. It'll all be over soon.
Indeed. Pretty useful, at least 3 duds have been removed. And there's only 3 left.
Nice.
Protectron will just make noise. At this point, there's no need to let it loose. Saw one more. This room. Some type of storage.
Think you can hide?
There's another one. Sometimes it's better.
Only a fucking coward hides.
Wait a moment. It's just on the other side.
Shit. Must have scared him off.
other side of the desk.
This is bullshit.
Saves on several prisoners. All of them will be dead by now. Authorized laser. That's interesting. Unlicensed laser again. Corrupted. I think only one of them was still incarcerated. Which means that may be this one right here.
Message to Alexander Strelnikov. My esteemed Mr. Strelnikov, I know someone of your profession values discretion above all else. But I have to honestly say, screw that. I mean, come on. One bullet, halfway across town, and you blew Ron Trevio's head clean off. You, sir, are an artist. Are all the assassins from Russia as good as you? I seriously doubt it. But listen, your secret's safe with me. Eddie Winter, signing off.
Two of them. One down the hallway, one up here. item that freezes him is pretty useful.
I'm just getting started.
Okay, one voice, female. Sounds like a raider.
Playing
by.
Games with me, huh?
Yeah. Pretty close to.
Come on out. I'll make it nice and quick. You can trust me.
This looks like a storage area. That is creepy. But at least I know where the key is. The chief's key. All of them. Maybe. That'll be good. Do the save first.
Nice.
I'll come back later and get the keys. Because I'd prefer to pick lock. That means experience.
There we go.
Well, this guy has bad luck. 3 days till retirement. And then a nuclear war. Cell keys, magnifying glass. What a few keys in here. I think I should be able to pick up the cell key without a problem. Interrogation. Looks like they were trying or attempting to get into this evidence area. And that turret was what was keeping them out.
Detective Valentine. Nick, listen, I'm sorry. You've got every right to be upset, but you need to believe me when I tell you I had no idea. Operation Winter's End was my baby. I believed in it. I still believe in it. They kept us all in the dark, me included. I got briefed this afternoon, and they laid it all out. The whole thing. His deal with the DA, his agreement to bring down the other families, his idea to record the holotapes and incriminate all known associates, and them needing a legitimate op and a real task force to make it all look like Winter was the focus. It was the plan all along, Nick. There's nothing we can do. Winter was a stoolie for the feds. He reported directly to the BADTFL, all on the books. For his cooperation, Winter will be granted total immunity.
It's over. Effective immediately, Operation Winter's End is to cease all investigations and operations. The task force is hereby disbanded. We played our part, pal. Not the part we thought, but hey, it happens. Now we're just another box in the file room. Nick, listen to me. Everything that's happened with Winter, with Jenny, it's more than any one man should have to handle. You need help. Boston PD has been working with the eggheads at CID. Some new program they have to deal with trauma. Scanning brain waves or some such.
Okay, that's interesting. Sounds like the scanning brainwaves is what they're working on with these synths. This sounds like something strange is going on. Might not be anything. Nick Valentine, one of the operators running Winter's End, led to the deaths of pre-war mob families, it sounds like. It's like the head equivalent of a Davy Crockett. Davy Crockett being tactical nuke. It launches over a small nuclear charge over a short period of time. Strange how that thing actually does exist. So there's precedence for the mini nuke launcher. Although it would have fired a lot further ways. Mini artillery. So this one's a bit more tactical. Sounds like something happened to Jenny or Jennifer. and Nick then went to get his brain scan to help with trauma. But that's how they are replicating some of these people I've seen who have synth versions of them, then might see someone else pre-war in the form of Nick Valentine. Sell some of this stuff and put the rest back at Grey Garden and then start exploring the area to the east of Tin Ponds. Amazes me how many small things I keep missing in Cambridge. I think you've explored it all and it turns out it's not the case. Must have been under this barrel or this generator the entire time. Anyway, season 4. Amazes me the fusion core was up here for that long. been out of this area for too long, so hopefully the only one things I run into until I get to Bunker Hill is ghouls and dogs. Mostly because those two would charge you, making them easier to handle. There's Bunker Hill right there. So there's quite a few collapsed buildings to explore. Some of them are open. Not much here though. Safe way up there. Amazes me the art's still in one shape and as it's faded. It's been 200 years, although it's not necessarily 200 years since this part of the building collapsed.
Got it.
But it's gonna be hard to figure out when it collapsed, but still, it's amazing that those paintings haven't faded. Due to rain and sun exposure. Looks like they might have been thinking about expansion, based on how those walls are set up.
Best not to talk to the raiders. They can get rough.
You have some sort of medical problem here, or are you just yanking my chain?
Two doctors.
I'm telling you, there's no such thing as junk. You know how to.
You have some sort of medical problem here, or are you just yanking my chain?
Yeah. I've machined up scopes out of Nuka-Cola bottles, put together landmines from.
Are you really a doctor?
My doctor? Let me show you my degree from the School of Saving Wise Asses like you. I'm a positive institution in these parts, so you need help or what?
Yeah. Take a look at me, Doc.
Tell me your problems.
No, we're done.
All right. Don't ruin my hard work by dying out there.
Make a move, and I'll end you, Wastelander.
Hey.
Again, step right up. Little bit of everything from all over.
I've got a few minutes to...
You may have to dig a little, but I got some choice stuff in there.
Might be useful, but I can't afford it just yet. Or this, for that matter. At least I can come back later. Okay. As soon as I do this last bit of scouting, I'm gonna drop it off at Grey Garden and continue. And that is simply to look at this area right here. Roughly. There are quite a few, it seems. May not have much in them, but they might. Raiders. Or in this case, ghouls.
R.A. Peters. It's March 1st. The subject has reached saturation threshold safely. Taking measurement now. Confirm 6 Sieverts. Rapid fluid loss due to fever. Up to IV intake. All previous symptoms are still present. Tissue damage visible on arms, neck and hands. Necrotic sloughing of the skin. Topical and ingested antibiotics applied to control infection. Now injecting first dose of serum sample 42BA7 into bloodstream. No immediate effects observed. Animal trials yielded results in less than...
So she's a subject. Hold on, this might explain a little bit more.
Entry 3, recorded by Research Assistant Peters on February 26, 2077. Time? It's 12:35 hours. Subject's direct radiation exposure level increased to 2 sieverts per 24 hours. Intravenous fluid intake increased to 1 liter. Subject reports localized pain in frontal and parietal lobe, accompanied by severe nausea, with vomiting on average, 3 to 6 instances per 12 hours. Solid food no longer viable by oral intake. Other symptoms include general weakness in limbs, bleeding of gums, severe abdominal cramps, and diarrhea. Dark stool indicates possibility of intestinal bleeding. Shortness of breath also an issue. I will now describe changes in mood or thought process. I have never in my life felt as horrible as I do right now. The discomfort is almost too much to bear. I often contemplate termination of this trial. But I know it'll only be a few more days before I reach 6 sieverts. Then I can administer the serum. We'll get our contract renewed. The serum will go to the market, and it's going to help people. It's really going to change the way we live. And me, I'll be... fine. I'll be fine. Cyclical thoughts. No other developments to report.
So this was February. Eight months until the nuclear war when she started this. When was this one?
Entry 6, R.A. Peters. It's March 1st. The subject has reached saturation threshold safely. Taking measurement now. Confirm 6 sieverts. Rapid fluid loss due to fever. Up to IV intake. All previous symptoms are still present. Tissue damage visible on arms, neck and hands. Necrotic sloughing of the skin. Topical and ingested antibiotics applied to control infection. Now injecting first dose of serum sample 42BA7 into bloodstream.
Sweet.
No immediate effects observed. Animal trials yielded results in less than...
There's a glowing one doing up here behind a locked door.
Second dose of sample 42BA7. Injected hours ago. No effect. No effect. I contacted the lab to terminate this trial, but... to talk to her. Hang on. What's that? Oh, my teeth. Oh, several teeth dislodged. Feels like necrotic tissue damage throughout oral cavity. Serum is ineffective at toxic levels. Request to terminate trial or... Martyrs are to remain in quarantine for the duration of the experimental period. I understand. I'm going to die. That's obvious. It's right here. Our failure. If you would, Dr. Roberts, please deliver the following to my family. Mom, Dad, I love you. Yes, I volunteered for this. It sounds crazy, but... I believed in it. There'll be nothing left worth burying. Just no way. Oh, no. That's a bit too sentimental. Let me think about it.
My guess is that was never passed on. And then this happened. So I don't know if... Well... Cure radiation sickness a lot easier. So she probably, likely turned into a ghoul before anyone else did. Skull from the sound of it. Otherwise, she would have had to survive from sometime after. No, the third one's probably in March, too. From March until October, and be turned into a ghoul. Let's just to make she was a ghoul before the bombs fell. And that would explain why she's a glowing one. If she was already a ghoul before the nuclear bombs fell, then she would have gotten even more radiation then. Thank you. the door dry cleaning. I think I'm... Yeah. I remember seeing that earlier. I don't think I've gone into it yet.